All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my page. I am back with another job lead, and this time it is for a clinical documentation coding specialist. So last week, if you saw my stories, I dropped a request for you to let me know what type of opportunities that you are looking for, and I would start posting job leads about those type of positions. And I picked out positions that people usually tell me that they have the most trouble finding, or there's a lot of misconceptions floating out there saying that it's not possible to get this type of job unless you have X, Y, and Z certification or education. So I like to use these as examples so that I can show you that it is possible to find job opportunities out there that align with your current level of experience and education if you use the right keywords. So I picked this position, clinical documentation coding specialist. The name of the company is UC Health. I've actually been following this company for quite a while because I noticed that they have quite a few opportunities available that are entry level, or they don't have as strict requirements for some of their positions. So I feel like this is a company that is willing to give new graduates the opportunity to get their foot in the door, or someone with, you know, minimal experience. So if you haven't already liked this page, make sure you like my page before I go any further into this. If you haven't subscribed already, make sure that you subscribe and you hit the bell notification so that you could be notified whenever I post these job leads. I do not expect for this position to be posted long after I post up this video. If you are inside of my private Facebook group, the free private Facebook group, you will see these job leads before it is posted here on my YouTube channel. So you have a leg up. Okay. And other than that, share this. If this is something that someone else you know might be interested in this position, make sure that you share this, because there are a lot of people out there that are looking for clinical documentation opportunities who are not nurses. So I do want to point out for this position here, it does not require for you to be a registered nurse or for you to be an LPN. It is not a requirement for this position. I'm just going to briefly go over the job duties. Okay, I'm not going to go into too much detail because the link for this job will be listed down below in the description. So briefly, before I go into the job description, clinical documentation is a professional who manages and assesses and reviews patients' medical records to ensure that all the information is documented and reflects the patient's severity of illness, clinical treatment, and the accuracy of documentation. A lot of companies do want you to be a nurse or an LPN, have some sort of clinical experience, but not all of them. There are a lot of other companies out here that will hire you without all of the clinical degrees that they request. Okay, so this position here, it says the job duties is queries the physicians while patients is in-house to aid physicians with proper and precise documentation and clarification for codes, reviews medical records and identify the payers as directed on admission, completes concurrent coding on the account throughout the stay of the patient, and obtains relevant documentation through extensive coordination between physicians, nursing, and other department and stakeholders. So let's get right into my favorite part, the requirements. Are you guys seeing what I'm seeing here? The requirements that they have listed here is high school diploma or GED, 2 years of relevant experience, certified clinical documentation specialist or clinical documentation improvement practitioner certifications, and also certified coding specialist. So for this particular position, I would not say that it is entry level, because you will need some sort of coding experience in the medical record. You would need to have at least 2 years under your belt of experience in order to go for this position. So like I tell you guys all the time, you can climb the career ladder in healthcare very quickly, but you have to plan out your career. You have to know when to pivot. You have to know when it's time to move. So if you are a coder, and you've been in the position for 2 years and you're ready to take the next step in your career, maybe you want to go up to clinical documentation specialist, you can do that. You should plan that out in your career. And after 2 or 3 years, start planning to apply for positions that is at the next level. So that's not a whole lot of years of experience, right? Some positions want you to have 5 years of experience before they even consider you for a coding position. But this particular position as a clinical documentation coding specialist, they're requested for you to have at least 2 years of experience. So that means that you can go to the next level in your career with only 2 years of experience as a medical coder for this position. You can go after this position if you only have your high school diploma and you completed a program that allowed you to get the Certified Coding Specialist credential or the CCDS or the CDIP. So that means that essentially you could have not attended an associate's degree program yet or a bachelor's degree or a master's degree program and still qualify for this position, still apply for this position after you get those 2 years of experience under your belt of medical coding. Right? If you already have been coding for more than 2 years, if you already have an associate's degree or a bachelor's degree or a master's degree, you already qualify as far as the education requirement. You overqualify. You've already surpassed having the high school diploma. So that is all valuable experience and education that you can leverage in order to get into this position. I'm going to remind you guys again, because I say it all the time. You can apply for this position, but your resume needs to be targeted. Okay, so if you run off here and go apply for the position and you do not target your resume for this position, it is not going to help you to get to the interview. Anyone who takes the time to target their resume for this particular position and apply will be the individuals who has the greatest chances of being selected for the interview. So I really love that this opportunity popped up on their website today. This is a new job posting. It was just posted today. I do not expect it to be up here for very long. You do not need an associate's degree, a bachelor's degree, a master's degree. You do not need to be an LPN. You do not need to be an RN. What you need is a high school diploma, 2 years of relevant experience. I'm going to call the relevant experience coding experience, okay? CDIP, CCDS, or CCS. This position is in Denver, Colorado. It is 100% remote. Let me point that out. This is a 100% remote opportunity. Like I showed you guys before in my past postings for job leads, I like to look inside of the job posting to see if there is a residency requirement. So I'm just gonna do a quick control F and then do residency. I don't see that. And then let's do miles. It doesn't say that you have to reside in the state of Colorado. It does not say that you have to be within a certain mile radius inside of the job posting. So if this is something that you are interested in, if you are a medical coder who's been in your position for longer than 2 years and you're ready to challenge yourself in your career and you're ready to take your career to the next level and you're interested in clinical documentation, I would highly recommend to check out this opportunity here. And then to point out here inside of the job posting, it does say here that the pay range for this position is $31.61 per hour to $47.41 per hour. I really love when jobs put the salaries inside of the job posting because it makes it easy for you to decide whether or not you even want to apply for the position or not. So on the low end, that's about $65,000 annually per year. Or at the top end, that is at $98,000 annually per year for this position. So that's a great salary for someone who may have only been in the healthcare industry or who only has 2 years of medical coding experience. That's a really great salary. That's a really great jump if you get into this position like that. And this is like the beginning stages of clinical documentation as far as the opportunities are that align with this type of position. This is really like the beginning stages. So you can climb the career ladder from this position into positions like CDI team lead, CDI supervisor, CDI denials manager, CDI manager, provider educator, coding manager. There's a lot of different opportunities that can stem from getting into a clinical documentation coding specialist role like this. So the link will be down below to apply for this opportunity. Again, I think this is an awesome opportunity for someone who has at least 2 years of coding experience and you have one of the credentials listed here. This is not an entry level opportunity. You will need to have a couple of years of experience up under your belt, but this is a great remote opportunity with a really great salary. So if there are any other videos that you want to see like this, any other job titles in particular, list them down below in the comments. If you have any questions, list them down in the comment. Don't forget to check out the description box below to see this job posting link, and then also to grab the free salary resource guide that I have, as well as the free HIM Job Search Kickstarter Masterclass, okay? Completely free. So grab all of that information down below, and don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss a beat.